नमस्ते शरण शरणार्थी वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल अगेन एमकेबी एकेडमी डियर चिल्ड्रन इन दिस वीडियो विल कंटिन्यू द लेसन पीपल एज अ रिसोर्स हियर क्वालिटी ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन हाउ अ कॉमन पॉपुलेशन आर कॉमन पीपल आर गोइंग टू बिकम क्वालिटी हाउ क्वालिटी दे विल गेट दैट इज बाय एजुकेशन एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी विल बी अंडरस्टैंडिंग the importance of the education, health care and the other skills, how helping to the people to become the quality population and how these quality people will be helping to the Indian economy. Okay, for your better understanding, let us start to see the slides. Thank you. Quality of population. Dear children, how a population or common people will become the quality people or the quality population. That is, literacy rate, health and the skills determine the quality of a population. Is it clear? The literacy rate, education rate and our health facility, health condition and the what other kind of different skills, these all the three things determine the quality of the population. Illiterate and the unhealthy population can be a liability for the economy. Meaning, illiterate people are uneducated people and illiterate people are there. Or people health condition is not good, then they cannot be involved in the any working condition. They cannot work it properly. Then how they could get the earning, isn't it? So, literate and the healthy population can be made into an asset for the economy. If literate people are there, if they learn different skills, if their health condition is good, then something work they can do. If they do the work, they do get the income. If they get the income, our country's income will be improving. Okay? Literate and healthy population contributes towards the GDP of a country. What is this GDP of the country? That is gross domestic production, total, what total India's economy will be there. This GDP will be improving if literate and the healthy population will be more. Let us understand the importance of the education. Education enhances the literacy level and skills level of a person. It also helps in enriching the culture of the society. Presence of educated person in the society indirectly benefits the illiterate persons as well. Here, children, education is most important. This education not only gives us the different skills, it also gives us own culture. It is good for our country also. So, even government has taken various steps to spread education among the people, because government know the importance of the education. Government strives to provide universal access to education, means without any discrimination, all the category people, all the level people are able to get education now. Even poor people also not excluded. Everybody should get the education. It also makes various plans to increase the retention of the students. A special emphasis is given on the girls' education because government knows properly that is the importance of the education. If many people will be getting the education, definitely that is going to help to the Indian economy. So government has made so many different plans. They are emphasizing the education, especially girls' education. They started to give more importance. What is that? Let us see. The plan outlay on education in the first plan was rupees 151 crore. It has increased to the rupees 43,825 crore in the 10th plan. Here, children, observe the development or the investment on the education. In the first plan, how many crores was invested on education? It is 151 crores. And it is increased in the 10th plan, that is 43,825 crores in the 10th plan. The expenditure on the education, how much money they started to invest in the education was 0.64% of the GDP in 1950 and 51. See, the 1950 and the 51, how much expenditure was there on the education in the GDP, that is 0.64, and it has increased to 3.98%, almost 4% of the GDP in the 2002 and the 2003. Means you just understand, in the year of 1950 to 51 and 2002 to 3, how much money they invested only on the education, because government knows the value of the education. Due to constant efforts, the literacy rate has grown from 18% in 1951 to more than 70% in the 2011. So how government efforts were there to improve the literacy rate? Initially, means in the 1951, just 18% was there. What is that literacy rate? And literacy rate increased to 70% in 2011. Literacy rate is higher among the males compared among the females. And moving on to the males and the females education, males literacy rate is high compared to the female highs, because for that some social reasons are there. You might have seen some rigid Hindu families and some rigid Muslim families are there. These are the families at that time, few years before, they were having their own views. They were not about to send their female child or girl child to send outside to get the education. So like that, so many reasons are there. So those kind of reasons, here female literacy rate is less. And comparing among the states, Kerala is a state with more than 90% literacy, while some states have a very low literacy level. And these are the reports in 2011 census, will get how different states literacy level is there, and also how literacy level is there among the men and the women, like this. The government recently launched Sarva Shikshana Abhiyan to spread education to remotest parts of the country. Under this program, all children under 6 to 14 years of age are given elementary education. Dear children, henceforth, I told you already, and the government knows the value of the education, they launched one program, that is Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. The main aim of this education is that they should spread the education to almost all the villages. Under this program, the children under 6 to 14 years of age, they should get the compulsory education. And also, government has started one more scheme or one more program, that is midday meal. What is this midday meal? Afternoon lunch will be provided to the children in the school. Government also provides a midday meal in the government schools, so that children of poor people can attend the school. Midday meal has helped many children from the poor family to attend the school. Children, this midday meal program attracted so many poor children towards the school, because there was a poverty, there were some poor families. How these families were there? Just for the sake of one time food or two time food, they used to work in hotels or some other working sectors instead of going to school. When government schools or government started to provide midday meal to the children in the afternoon, then the children started to go to the schools and they started to get education. Fine. The 10th plan has focused on increasing the enrollment in higher education from 6% to the 9%. Then moving on to the next higher education, only 6% enrollment school going children were there. They wanted to develop it, or they wanted to increase it from 6% to the 9%. So 10th year plan completely focused on that. The strategy is to increase access, quality and adoption of state-specific curriculum to motivate the enrollment in the higher education. Totally, in the higher education, state government curriculum and the central government schemes and plans, what will be there altogether, they will be working. Their main aim is that they should increase the students in the higher education. Vocational courses are also offered under use of information technology is being maximized to the attain the goal. The 10th plan also focuses on distance education, convergence of formal and the non-formal and the IT education. Totally, higher education, different courses, what will be there? These all got importance by the 10th plan. So in these all the slides and the government schemes, just you should understand that how government is investing more on the education. Why they are investing more on the education itself? Because education is good, important, is most important for the healthy population. And this here you can see, what is this? 1950-51, the number of colleges, number of universities, number of students and number of the teachers, and 80-98 and the 99, how it is increased. This is just one strategy to make you to understand that how there was a development in the matter of the education. Thank you. Then what is this? Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, SSA, is an Indian government program aimed at the universalization of the elementary education in a time-bound manner as mandated by the 86th Amendment to the Constitution of India, making free and compulsory education to the children of the ages 6 to 14. Here children, from the age 6 to 14, what children will be there? They made some changes in the constitution. They amended it. As per this new amendment, 6 to 14, how many children, aged group children will be there? These all the children, compulsory, they should get education. And it was estimated that in the 2001, 205 million in the numbers. These are the people. A fundamental right. This is getting education. It is a fundamental right as per this new amendment of the constitution. The program was pioneered, means initially introduced by Atal Bihar Vajpayee. Then after understanding the importance of the education in this video, in the next video we will understand the importance of the health and the other things. So keep in touch. Thank you.